This video will demonstrate a bifrontal craniotomy for resection of medial frontal arteriovenous malformation and clipping of anterior communicating artery aneurysm. The patient was in her early 70s. She presented with severe headache and left-sided weakness. On neurological examination, she was plegic in the arm and densely weak in the leg. Her CT scan demonstrates a large hematoma within the frontal lobe. CT angiogram demonstrated an underlying tangle of vessels with marked venous filling draining to the inferior sagittal sinus and straight sinus. These images also show how the hematoma nicely separated the lateral border of the AVM from the frontal lobe. Here is her angiogram in AP and lateral views. These images show the right carotid injection filling the AVM, primarily through small anterocerebral artery branches. The left carotid shows that the AVM filled predominantly from the left through large crossing anterocerebral arteries. This table shows the AVM grading. This was a Spetzler-Martin grade 2 AVM with 2 points for size and a Lawton-Young grade 3 AVM with 3 points for age. A bifrontal craniotomy was selected here with the patient supine, head turned 90 degrees to the right and angled upwards 45 degrees. Note that the craniotomy crosses the superior sagittal sinus. Here are the key surgical steps. The head position, as described earlier, was 90 degrees rotated to the right and 40 degrees angled upwards. A C-shaped scalp incision was used with a bifrontal craniotomy and the dural flap upwards towards the sinus. Next, intrahemispheric dissection for identification of ACA feeders in the region of the rostrum, identification of dominant draining veins coursing posteriorly to the inferior sagittal sinus, development of a line of demarcation between the normal cingulate and the inferior AVM border, identification of a large anterocerebral feeding artery anteriorly, which was controlled with an aneurysm clip, dissection laterally into the adjacent hematoma, and finally en bloc removal of the AVM. Lastly, an anterocommunicating artery aneurysm, which was identified angiographically, was then clipped through the intrahemispheric corridor. Here's an overview of the surgical approach. The superior sagittal sinus and midline are at the top of the screen. The forehead is to the right, and the occiput is to the left. Here, my fellow begins with evacuation of the hematoma around the AVM nidus. Next, the dissection moves into the interhemispheric fissure where these large anterocerebral feeding arteries are identified. Here is one of those which comes up and bifurcates into two large feeding arteries. The anterior branch here is cauterized and divided. Notice how it sits right on top of an underlying vein. Here, the posterior branch is cauterized and divided as well, with care taken to preserve the en passage artery running behind it. This forms a line of demarcation on the inferior border of the AVM, and the hematoma underneath is encountered. The dissection now moves anteriorly, defining this inferior border of the AVM. Additional feeding arteries are identified on this inferior margin, again, taking care to preserve the en passage normal arteries. These are swept away from the inferior border of the nidus. The hematoma undermined the nidus, and by defining this border, we can quickly evacuate hematoma and define the planes around the nidus. Now the dissection continues on the posterior margin, here separating the nidus from normal cortex posteriorly. The draining veins were coursing in this posterior direction, and these are carefully protected. Dissection is now coursing above the AVM, and the hematoma cavity is entered from above. Here, this posterior separation plane is developed further. At this point, attention is turned to the anterior pole. I'm coming around the anterior margin here. The AVM is now being separated from normal cortex in the front. Here is this large feeding artery that supplies the AVM. The artery dilated markedly at this bifurcation point, and therefore it needed to be controlled with this aneurysm clip. This clip nicely takes out this feeding artery supply, which was significant, And now we can cauterize and divide this artery. This eliminates the remaining major supply to the AVM. The nidus is now based posteriorly on the venous pedicle, which now is being circumdissected and transected. Here you can see that vein. It's now blue in color. It can be cauterized underneath this overlying artery and transected. This will release the nidus so that it can be removed. Here's the nidus as it's lifted out of its resection cavity. And you can see the underlying hematoma cavity has been emptied out. Now that the AVM is removed, we can turn our attention to the ACOM aneurysm. This is a nice view over the rostrum of the corpus callosum. Here the A2 segments are being followed down along the rostrum in front of the genu, and we follow these vessels all the way down to the anterior communicating artery complex. Here the aneurysm comes into view. It's very thin-walled and cherry red in color. You see the adjacent A2s are whitish in color, and here with a full curved clip, we can occlude the neck. Here's a high magnification view of that aneurysm and its well-clipped anatomy. Here's an overview of our surgical corridor. These illustrations show the surgeon's view for the medial frontal AVM. The cube defines the feeding arteries and draining veins. Feeding arteries are primarily from callosomarginal and pericallosal arteries. The dissection steps are shown in the lower illustrations. These illustrations show the AVM in the dependent position so that the AVM has to be dissected and mobilized upwards out of the medial frontal lobe. The patient tolerated the procedure well. She had some transient worsening of her left-sided weakness, but this improved with rehabilitation. Postoperative angiography showed complete AVM resection. In conclusion, the anterior interhemispheric approach is optimal for medial frontal AVMs based on the medially presenting surface. Interhemispheric access allows for early identification and control of arterial supply, as well as protection of en-passage anterocerebral artery vessels and medially draining veins. Hematomas associated with ruptured AVMs provide a helpful dissection plane, as well as a route for rapid decompression of the brain. Medial frontal AVMs that extend beyond 2 centimeters from the midline may benefit from a contralateral interhemispheric approach that pulls the AVM medially and improves visualization of the lateral margin. Thank you.